We brought books and cards, dice, dollar bills, and let's look and see. One of the things we think about, and I have a wooden box, and in that wooden box is a die, a single die, and it has numbers on it from 1 to 6. And I am going to take this die, and may I hand you the wooden box? Yes, thank you. Then it can find a die. And I'm going to step away, and I'm going to ask you in a moment to open that wooden box. And then, when you do, I'm going to ask you, please, out of my visual sight line, I'm going to have you take that die out. And then I'm going to have you, please, put the die into the box, either with the number you want facing up or the number facing down. And I'm going to ask you, please, to remember that number. You may show it to those around you. And then I'll have you put it in the box and close the box with the wooden lid so there's no way anyone can get to that die. And so there's no way anyone can know what that number is other than those to whom you show it. And I will turn my back now, not to be rude, I'm going to apply counting off my balding cane. And when you're ready, I'm going to say, Dave, we are ready.
Okay.
Very good. You have a number. Now, are you thinking of the number facing up, or are you thinking of the number facing down?
Facing down.
Facing down, the number facing down. And this reminds us when we are in practice, once you all complete your training and you're out in practice, it becomes very important. Numbers are critical. We need to know vital signs. Those are numbers. We need to know doses of medications. Those are numbers. It's important as you're studying and studying your pharmacology, as you are studying your physical exam skills, to keep numbers in mind. And I just to warm up here right now, you're thinking of a number. Please get this number correct. I want you all to be excited because the number you're reminding us of with that number is when we dose medications for patients, we can do it daily. We can do it twice a day, BID dosing. We can do it 3 times a day, BID dosing. In fact, however, you put a number down, it reminds us. Some medications require QID 4 times a day. Is the number 4 the number you're thinking of? Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay. Please. look at a card, let it drop down, I'll take the deck back. Thank you. You will do one more card, please. I won't look, I'll have you pop it open, look at a card, I'll have you hand the deck back, and I'll have you stand up if you will. Thank you. Very good. I'll have you all stand up. Now, I don't want you all to do anything yet. In a moment, I'm going to ask you all please to picture your card in your mind. Project it to me. Very good. I'm getting four images. Please don't do anything yet. I'm getting an image of a three of clubs, picking up an eight of spades. I just picked up a queen of hearts and a five of diamonds. Now, if I named your card, I'd like you all to please sit down. Thank you. Now, one card was selected early from the deck. At random, you have that card. No one has seen that card yet. I don't think you've even seen it yet. We have no idea what the card is. 52 cards and two jokers, you selected one card at random. And it reminds us later in the year when we study medical jurisprudence and medical ethics, how important it is to be aware of the concept of the contract of insurance. So you see, we want to be certain that as practicing physicians, we have an insurance policy that protects us and our practice. And we'll talk about malpractice insurance within the year. As a magician, I have to carry an insurance policy as well. And my policy says, conditions of this policy, all parties involved must be playing with a full deck. It says, please look to the terms of your policy. So we will look to the terms of our policy, and you see the policy tells me that you selected a card. Would you please show us the card you selected? You're still thinking of that month and day. Earlier, I handed somebody a calendar that is rubber banded shut. Is that correct? Yes, you have that calendar. Without opening it or looking at it, I am going to ask you, if you will, just to hold it up so everyone can see that you are holding up a calendar. Very good. And a deck of cards, which again can be verified. These cards are almost as mixed up as ours. And I'm going to ask if I may. I am going to ask, would you please say stop at any time?
Stop.
Very good. Please. Without looking, I'm going to remove that card, just set it face down on your table. You could have had any card you wanted. That was the card you selected. The calendar. If I may ask, would you please take the rubber band off and open up the calendar? And would you please verify that in fact, when you look through that calendar, interestingly enough, every day in that calendar has a card, playing card and suit, handwritten at that date. Is that correct? Yes, every day from January 1st to December 31st, a playing card is written in there. Now, I'm going to ask, a date was selected, is that correct? You just merely thought of a month and a day. Didn't tell me or anyone else. No one has any idea what it is. I'm going to ask you please to announce out loud the actual month you're thinking of. day did you think? The seventh. Now I'm asking you please to look to October 6th, if you will. October 6th, what playing card is there at October 6th? Three of Hearts. But you didn't pick October 6th. What if you look at October 8th? What playing card do you see? Ten of Spades. But you didn't pick October the 8th, did you? You picked October 7th. Now, before you call out October 7th, when we practice mass, when we engage in collegiality, working together with colleagues, and we also want to work together with our patients to create rapport, a link with them, we want to engage in what's known as synchronicity, where we're working together, feeling that sense of energy, feeling and perform cranial sacral. When we're engaging in muscle energy, or counter strength. So you see, we want the synchronicity. You thought of a month and a day at random. You have the calendar, and you're looking at a card. You selected a card at random from a shuffled deck, and you have it now in front of you. I'm going to ask you, please, to share out loud what actual playing card is there at October 7th. The King of Hearts. Would you please pick up your card and show us if we have complete synchronicity? And your card is the King of Hearts. Thank you.
Please, when you select your word or two words, you may rely on a colleague as well
I'll have you point to those words to those around you so that they can see the words. Please do not verbalize them, I do read lips. So, I will turn my back and ask you now to go through the book and open up wherever you want the book. I'm going to ask you, please, comfortably, take your time and comfortably scan, and please find silently the biggest word, the longest word, most letters, most syllables. And if you're conflicted between more than one word, you may select two. And once you've found that word or words, I want you just to say, Dave, I'm ready. Please, to share out loud with us how many pages there are in that book.
199.
Now I'm going to ask, please, if I may, from 1 to 199, what page would you like? 80. I'm going to ask you, please, to turn to page 80 in your book. Now I'm going to ask you, if you will, when you turn to page 80, I'm going to ask you, please, to look at the first line at the top of page 80. And I'm going to ask you to silently select on that first line at the top of page 80. The biggest word, the longest word, most letters, most syllables. It'll make this the most impressive. And as you look at it, then I'm going to have you please close the book. You both have that word, yes? Have you sent the book forward? Very good. We have lots of words floating around. And if I may, I may take your card back from you. Thank you. And I may take the box of dye back. Excellent. Because when I wrap up, I know you all want to proceed forward, so I don't want to have to go around collecting things. I know there's still a calendar out there, and I'll plug that back. There's a dictionary in some of these words. Lots of words. One word or two words can we select from? One word. Please do not tell us your word. I am going to ask you to share out loud the first letter of your word. The letter R. The letter R in and of itself does not tell us anything. In fact, it's similar to when a patient presents to us. The first time we see the patient, into their chart or their electronic medical record, goes a little bit of information. The R. The next time we see them, we get another piece of information. Metaphorically, it may be an E. The next time they come to us, we may get another piece of information. Metaphorically, a C. And you see, the unconscious mind goes to a word that has meaning. Because we all realize and understand that when we're out in medical practice, the reality is, the first impression a patient receives is when they come to our office. And the first person they see is the most important person in our office, because the word you're thinking of is R-E-C-E-P-T, receptionist. Is that correct? Yes. And you selected a word at random when I just riffled through the book and I said, please, say stop at any page and you stop. And it reminds us that we want to establish rapport with our patients. We don't want to see our relationship with other patients as us and them. or self and others. Is that right? With T-H-E-R-S.
Yeah.
Someone selected a page at random. You turned to that page at random. Is that right? And you all selected a word at random, both of you, from that page at random. And before we think about that word, I am going to ask, yes, in the dictionary, there are four columns, two on each page. We've got columns 1, 2, 3, and 4, am I right? What column would you like? 1, 2, 3, or 4? Yeah, 2. Matt, please look at column 2. While you're looking at column 2, we are reminded that when patients come to us, we have to be willing to work with them. We're there for their needs. We're there for their process. And sometimes we may have to make for the patient accommodations after that. You're looking at column 2, and I'd like you please to look at the first bold print word at the top of column 2, the first defined word. Silently looking at that reminds us that when patients present to us, we have to take into account all of their frailties, all of their issues, and especially if we're practicing pediatrics, family practice, or child and adolescent psychiatry, we have to be aware that some of our patients are going to suffer from DYS, LEXIA, dyslexia. Is that correct? Thank you all.